Good morning, student. I welcome you to my class. Today I am going to teach you a new lesson, Footprints Without Print. It is chapter number 5 of your supplementary reader and written by H.G. Wells. Now the full name of H.G. Wells is Herbert George Bell. H.G. Wells means Herbert George Wells. He was born on 25th September 1866 in England. He was a great writer who wrote novels, history and science fiction. So he used to write novels, history and science fiction. The most famous work of H.G. Wells are The Time Machine. So children, The Time Machine is one of the most famous work of H.G. Wells. Then The Invisible Man and The Island of Dr. Moreau. He died on 13 August 1946. Now children, I would like to discuss you the important point of the story along with the theme of the story. So let me tell you something about the theme of the story. Now the story Footprints Without Feet describes the story of a very brilliant scientist whose name was Griffin. So what was the name of that scientist? The name was Griffin, who degenerated himself into a lawless person. Now because of some need, because of some problem which he was facing, Griffin discovered that human body could become transparent and invisible. But he misused his great discovery. He did use the power of invisibility for the welfare of the society and humanity at large. So children, he had discovered the power of invisibility, but that he started using not for the welfare of the society and not for the humanity at all. He misused it to threaten, trouble and beat innocent persons and rob them. So what he used to do, he used to beat innocent person, used to misuse it to threaten, trouble and beat innocent person and rob them. He made illegal entries in stores and shops. So when he became invisible, he used to make illegal entries in stores and shops and stole things from there. He committed a burglary in a clergyman's house in Iping. Griffin remained invisible or unseen only when he was without clothes. So children, only thing when he used to become invisible when he was without clothes. If he put on clothes, he lost his invisibility and could be seen by the people around him. The lesson gave a message: the misuse of science and its great discoveries can make even a brilliant scientist like Griffin a monster and a threatening, lawless person. So what is the main message of the story? That the misuse of science and its great discovery can make even a brilliant scientist like Griffin a monster and a threatening, lawless person. Okay, so now I will be telling you the summary point wise. So this story is interesting. It is a story of a scientist who misused his science. He used to become invisible when he used to take out his clothes when he was naked. Then he used to take advantage. He used to go inside the store. He used to go inside the shop for theft. Okay, and he used to sometimes beat the innocent people. He misused it to threaten the people also. So the message that misuse of science and a great discovery can make even a brilliant scientist like Griffin a monster and a threatening, lawless person. So this is the theme of the story. Now I will be telling you the summary and the background of the chapter point wise. So my first point is muddy imprints. Muddy imprints. Okay, so two boys were highly surprised. They saw muddy impression on the step of a house in London. They were the fresh footmarks of a barefooted man. The boys followed them. The impression got fainter and finally disappeared. So children, two boys were highly surprised when they found a muddy impression on the steps of a house in London. They were the fresh footprints of a barefooted person. The boys followed them. The impression got fainter and finally disappeared. Now children, my second point is mystery of footmarks. Mystery of footmarks. The mystery of footmark was quite simple. The boys were following a scientist. He had just discovered how to make the human body invisible or transparent. So what was the mystery, children? The mystery of footmarks was quite simple. A scientist was there, and when he used to take out his clothes, he used to become transparent and invisible. So he was invisible, he was going, and the boys were following that scientist. They were not knowing that a human being is there. He had just discovered how to make the human body transparent. Okay, now my third point is Griffin is great but eccentric scientist. Griffin was a great scientist. He carried out many experiments to prove that human body could become invisible. In the end, he swallowed some rare drugs and his body became transparent. So children, Griffin, this was done by a great scientist whose name was Griffin. He carried out many experiments to prove that human body could become invisible. In the end, he swallowed some rare drugs and his body became transparent. He was a lawless person. His landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. In revenge, Griffin set his house on fire. So he was a very cruel-hearted person. Okay, he was a scientist. He had started doing many experiments to prove that human body could become invisible. In the end, he swallowed some rare drugs and his body became transparent. He was a lawless person. His landlord disliked him and tried to eject him. In revenge, Griffin set his house on fire. Unseen when naked. So my fourth point is unseen when without clothes or naked. Griffin had to remove all his clothes. He wanted to be unseen by the people. He became a homeless wanderer without clothes. He had no money. He left footmark as he walked. Now, my fifth point is in a big London store. The air was bitterly cold. Griffin was naked. Instead of walking about the street, he entered a big store in London for warmth. He enjoyed the pleasure of clothes and food freely. He fitted himself out with warm clothes there. He became fully dressed up with shoes, an overcoat and a hat. After putting on clothes, he became visible. He had cold meat and coffee, sweets and wine from the grocery store. He slept on a pile of quilts. He did not wake up until the assistant arrived next morning. When they came near, he panicked and began to run. But he could become invisible only he was totally naked. So he took off his newly found clothes. Once more he became naked in the chill January air. In a dreary land. Now my sixth point is in a dreary land. He hurried to Dreamland, the center of the theater world. He found a shop he was searching. He came upstairs invisible. He came out of the shop wearing bandages around his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, side whiskers, and a large head. Then he attacked a shopkeeper and dropped him off all the money he could find. Now, arrival in Iping village. Arrival in Iping village. Griffin wanted to get away from the crowded London. He came to the village Iping. He booked two rooms in a local inn. Arrival of a stranger of such strange appearance became the talk of the people. Mrs. Hall tried to be friendly with her guest Griffin. He told that he did not want to be disturbed. He wanted to be alone. She thought that her guest was an eccentric scientist. She did not mind his strange habit and irritable temper. Griffin cash finished. He told a lie that he was expecting a check at any moment. So children, he arrived in Iping village. Okay. And he did not want to stay in the crowded London. He came to a village Iping. He booked two rooms in a local inn. Arrival of a stranger of such strange appearance became the talk of the people. Nobody liked his appearance. Some suspense and some mysteries were there in his appearance. Mrs. Hall tried to be friendly with her guest Griffin. He told that he did not want to be disturbed. He wanted to be alone. She thought that her guest was an eccentric scientist. She did not mind his strange habits and irritable temper. Griffin Cash finished, he told Eli that he was expecting a check at any moment. Now, clergyman burgled. My 8th point is, a strange episode occurred. A clergyman and his wife were awakened by the noise in the study very early in the morning. They came downstairs and heard the chink of money being taken from the desk. With a poker in his hand, the clergyman flung open the door. He shouted, "Surrender!" He was surprised to see the room empty. They looked under the desk, behind the curtains, even up the chimneys. No one was there. They found the desk open and the money was missing. They were highly surprised, could not understand anything. Now, Mrs. Hall's furniture shows a strange behavior. Now, my next point is, so the landlord and his wife, Mrs. Hall, woke up early in the morning. They found Griffin door wide open. Usually it was shut and locked. They peeped around but found nobody. They found Griffin clothes and bandages were lying about. Usually Griffin's door was shut and locked. When they peeped around, what did they found? There was nobody inside the room. They found Griffin clothes and bandages were lying about. All of a sudden, Mrs. Hall heard a sniff close to her ear. A hat leaped up and dashed itself into her face. Then the chair became alive. They turned away in fear. Then chair pushed them both out of the room. Then the door was slammed and locked after them. Mrs. Hall almost fell down the stair and started crying. They were sure that the room was haunted by a spirit. The villagers suspected that the trouble was caused by witchcraft. When the news of burglary at the clergyman's home became known, everyone doubted Griffin's hand in it. The suspicion grew stronger when Griffin suddenly showed some ready cash. He had no cash before a few days. Now, the next important point is, invisible man shows himself. Man shows himself. Mrs. Hall went to Griffin's room. He was there. She asked what he was doing to her chair upstairs. She also asked how he entered a locked room. The scientist lost his temper. He became furious and cried, "I will show you." Suddenly he threw away all bandages, whiskers, spectacles, and even nose. The horrified man in the bar were staring at a headless man. Now, So, children, Invisible Man shows himself. Mrs. Hall went to Griffin room. He was there. She asked what he was doing in her chairs upstairs. She also asked how he entered a locked room. The scientist lost his temper. He became furious and cried, "I will show you." Suddenly, he threw away all bandages, whiskers, spectacles, and even nose. The horrified man in the bar were staring at a headless man. Encounter with Constable Jeffords. The police constable, who had been informed, arrived now. He was totally surprised to find that he was to arrest a man without a head. There followed a wonderful scene. The scientist, that is Griffin, started throwing his clothes one by one. He was becoming more and more invisible as he threw off one garment after another. Finally, the man became invisible. Some people who tried to hold him were beaten by the unseen blows that came from nowhere. In the end, Jeffo was knocked unconscious. Nervous and excited people were crying, "Hold him." Griffin was invisible and free now. No one knew where to lay hands on him. So, children, this is the story. Okay. The policeman tried to get hold of a man who started throwing his garment one by one and became invisible. Jeffords and the people who came to help him were hit by blows from nowhere. Jeffords was knocked unconscious when he tried to hold on to the unseen scientist. So, children, Griffin was that extraordinary and a brilliant scientist. He discovered that human body could become invisible and transparent as a sheet of glass. It was the result of his long and constant experimentation. However, he misused his discovery only for his personal gain, committing thefts and burglaries and beating and robbing innocent person. He could have earned fame and respect had he utilized his great discovery for the welfare of humanity. But his activities made him a lawless and an artist. His invisibility was possible only when he did not wear any clothes. If dressed up, he could lose his invisibility. He had to remain without clothes even in the chilly weather of midwinter to remain invisible. He had to make illegal and burglaries in a clergyman's house. So he made a illegal entry and he had done a burglary. He stole in a clergyman house a big, which was, he entered in a big store in London and a shop in Drury Lane. This brought him disrepute and dishonor instead of fame and respect. So it is clear, children, science, if we will misuse it, it will, and its great discoveries can make even a brilliant scientist like Griffin a monster and threatening, lawless person. He did not even leave Jeffo, who was a village constable. He is a very determined person. He is called to the inn when the stranger unveiled himself and created confusion. He was quite surprised to find that he had to arrest a man without a head. But Jeffords could not be easily prevented from doing his duty. The constable tried to catch hold of a person whom he could not see at all. In the end, Jeffords made the last attempt to hold on to an unseen scientist. Griffin Jeffords was knocked down unconscious. Okay, so children, this is all. And now I will be telling you I will be reading you and explaining you the story. Okay. So, the two boys started in surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. Two boys were there. They started in surprise at the fresh muddy imprints of a pair of bare feet. Muddy is full of mud. Imprints means impression of a person. Children, that muddy imprints of a person, of a pair of bare foot, can be seen on the stairs, on the step of a house in the middle of London. And where was the man? But they could not see any man who was there. As they gazed, gazed means to look, a remarkable sight met their eyes. Remarkable means noticeable. So, a noticeable sight can be, they saw a remark, noticeable sight met their eyes, a fresh footmark. Footmark is a footprint. Okay, a fresh footmark appeared from nowhere. So what they have seen? They have seen that a fresh footmark, the print of a foot was seen, which they don't know from where it appeared. Further footprints followed one after another, descending the steps and progressing down the street. And they further noticed that the four children, they started following that footprints. And suddenly, children, what they noticed? That the footprints followed one after another. It was descending the steps and progressing down the street. The boys followed fascinated until the muddy impression became fainter and fainter and at last disappeared altogether. So children, the boys, they were following, they were noticing that footprints, and finally, children, that footprints, it became lighter, and then finally it fainted. It did not appear to them. So these two boys, they were very much surprised that nobody is there, and the fresh footprint, which has now become fainter and invisible, can be seen. So thank you and have a nice day. In my next video class, I will continue the rest part of the story. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Bye bye.